What's up, family? It is Kaden with Urban Finance. Last week, we had a beautiful week in the stock market, and I had one stock that was up over 134% just in that week. And so we'll talk about, is that stock still a good buy in this video? So there were three stocks that I mentioned that would be a good buy if Biden won the election. And quite frankly, I talked about how this entire industry will benefit from a Biden win. And it really looks like Biden is gonna win this thing. So I'm feeling very hopeful for these three stocks. But if there's any chance that he loses, or if he loses, which I don't think would happen, I would probably sell out of this industry just because of the volatility that will happen as a result. It's probably be volatile regardless, but if Biden lose, it's gonna get worse. The first stock that I mentioned was Aurora Cannabis. And so this was my big winner for last week. I was up personally about 125% on this stock. And for last week, the stock was up 134%. So if you picked this one up last week, you are sitting lovely on this stock. Now, I did mention that I do think that the stock overall probably could have a 100-point gain in about a year or so, but you know, hey, I'll take it in a week, why not? With that being said, given how volatile the market is now, given that the primary catalyst for the run-up for Aurora was the fact that there were a couple of states that legalized marijuana, as well as the fact that Joe Biden is probably gonna win, when it ran up 121st, personally, I put a stop loss on it. I really did not want to sell out of Aurora, but I also did not want to give up the gains that I had. And so I did put a 15% stop loss on Aurora, which unfortunately, the stock during the course of that day ran down 15% and triggered my stop loss. So I end up selling out of all of my shares of Aurora at 110% gain. So still a pretty nice gain, but not necessarily what I 100% wanted to do. But I also wanted to take the emotional aspect of the sell out of the stock, especially with Aurora. It has some pending litigations right now. And on top of that, it has had extreme challenges during the pandemic. And so the stock, as we talked about last week, dropped from almost $100 down to about four something where it was last week. And now it's trading about $10. And so that's a pretty significant gain over the week, but the stock is still pretty down. I do think Aurora is still a good buy. And even though my stop loss was triggered and I sold out of it, I potentially will buy back into Aurora if it hits $7. And so that's my price for Aurora. If Aurora goes down to $7, I'll probably buy back into it. Because Aurora is probably one of the most popular cannabis stock, especially on Robinhood as well, I wouldn't be surprised if it hits $15 next week. But I also won't be surprised if it hits my buy price, which is $7. So the second stock that we talked about, and I actually picked up an additional 75 shares of this stock to have a 100 share position, is Aphria. Overall, I had a 20% growth in Aphria last week, so still a pretty decent gain. But I do think Aphria has a lot of room to run. Now, this stock is gonna run a lot slower than Aurora for two reasons. The first being that it just have more shares of this stock. And so unless institutional buying starts happening in Aphria, which I do think it will eventually, I don't think this stock is gonna run up as fast as an Aurora would. But I do think overall this company have much better sound of fundamentals than Aurora, which is why I took the money from Aurora and purchased more of Aphria stock. And so while this stock is only up 20% compared to other stocks in the industry that has significant gains like an Aurora of 100%, I do think this is a solid long-term play. And so I invested 100 shares into this particular stock. The last stock that I picked up and I added more shares to last week was CGC, Canopy Growth Corporation. And so Canopy Growth Corporation is currently the industry leader in terms of market capitalization. So it's the largest company, and unlike Aurora and Aphria when I picked them up, it was not a penny stock. So this stock was already trading at $19 when I picked it up, and I picked up a few additional shares last week at about $20 or $21. It is more pricey, but you're honestly paying for what you get, the industry leader in the cannabis industry, which is projected to be growing 25% year over year, 15% for some of the medical brands. But what I would say, some of the leaders in the industry may grow even even faster than that. And so I do think CGC is a good solid long-term play. So I only picked up an additional 5 shares of this because I wanted to get to 100 shares of Aphria before their stock significantly increases. So my goal here is I will try to pick up as many shares as CGC over the next few months, preferably under $27. If you've been following me for this channel, you know I add $500 into my Robinhood account every month, and I started doing that back in June. So that is actually not a ton of money that I'm putting into this account. So it's not a lot of shares of any particular stocks that I can pick up all at one time. For example, 25 shares of CGC will totally spend my $500 for next month. So I probably would not pick up a full 25 shares of CGC just because there are other companies outside of the cannabis industry that I am looking at, and I don't want to put all of my eggs in one basket, especially a basket that's gonna be very volatile like this particular industry. Now, I think this is one of the high growth industries along with EVs and along with artificial intelligence, but with growth come volatility. With volatility comes the chance to lose money. And you know Warren Buffett rule is don't lose money. So right now I'm holding 2 companies in the cannabis industry. I'll probably pick up another cannabis stock in order to create 3 cannabis stocks, because I would like to hold 3 stocks in the industry to kind of have like a cannabis ETF where I'm more focused on the overall return of the group than I am on the one specific stock. Because like I said, especially with an Aurora, or especially like the other stock that I may pick up, a Tilray, those stocks may be even more volatile than an Aphria or a CGC. And so while holding those stocks, it's gonna go up, it's gonna go down, and it's gonna be an emotional roller coaster. One rule I do have with stocks, especially if I'm up a lot like Aurora, is that if I'm unable to sleep at night, even if the stock is doing well, I'll probably set a stop loss. And that way, I don't have to think about, am I giving up too much of my gains? And I can sleep a lot sounder knowing that I have a stop loss on that stock. I can't remember if I mentioned this, but for CGC, I would like to pick that up between 23 and 27. If it goes above that, I will not add to my position. I may add additional in Aphria or pick up the 3rd stock that I would like to add to my personal ETF here. If and when I do pick up that next stock, I will certainly let you know what it is. So for those of you that did not see my last video, make sure you check it out, because this will give you a very solid idea of when to potentially sell the stocks as well, because I do give a target price point. Well, I go through the Morningstar review of these stocks and show you the different stocks and the target price points that these stocks are projected to hit. There were also several other stocks in the cannabis industry that you can also check out to add to your watch list or potentially add to your position if you so choose. But certainly go check that video out. It will give you more details on these stocks and how you may want to position yourself. I am not a financial advisor. This is not financial advice. This is just some moves I'm making in the stock market right now. And let me be clear about this. This is one industry that is going to be very, very volatile over the next year. And if you can't handle that volatility, do not jump in. As well as if you can't lose the money that you're putting into here. And I know number one rule is don't lose money, but especially with a high growth industry with this, where there is a lot of speculations on, is cannabis going to get legalized in the federal level? Are more states going to legalize it? What that's going to look like? There's going to be volatility. But I think this is one industry that, especially if you can hold these stocks for the next 5 years or so, you're probably guaranteed growth. If you have any questions at all, drop them in the comment section below. If you're purchasing or have purchased or considering purchase any stocks in the cannabis industry, let me know what stocks you're looking at. I'll probably check them out myself. If you haven't already, go ahead and smash the like button, subscribe to the page, and hit the bell to be notified of when I post something new. And like I always say, God bless you, and make sure you live your best life.